Everyone, it's Jeff, the laid-back retro gamer. I haven't made a video for a while, probably a good four and a half weeks. I was kind of on of a bit of a hiatus, and then I was back for a little bit, and then, you know, had a bunch of other things coming up, you know, just everyday life going on, and couldn't really get to the computer as much as I would like to. But this is going to be a little bit of a channel update. Nothing too serious, you know, it's just I only really picked up like one game. I'll just show you guys that real quick, and then you know, just talk about a little bit about what's been going on with myself and my channel. So first up, I had a gift certificate coupon for a website called spun.com. Very cool. It's actually owned by the same company that owns Trans World Entertainment, which is stores like FYE and Coconuts, and I don't know if Coconuts is still around, but it used to also be called The Wall. But anyway, so yeah, for like every $100 that you spend on the site, 2 months later you get issued a $5 gift certificate towards basically anything on the store. And I had a couple dollars left in store credit from another time when I sold some games, so I had about almost $8, I guess, you know, accumulated between both of those things. So I saw this game here, brand new for PlayStation 3. It's called MX vs. ATV Untamed. By THQ. It's going to be kind of hard to see. I don't really have the best lighting in my room. But, yeah, my nephew was actually a little bit interested in checking that out, and it actually came out to around 13-something, you know, with the tax and the shipping. But after about the $8 came off, I only paid about 5 and change, about maybe $5.30-something cents, so that was cool. I just got that. It's still sealed, actually. When my nephew comes home from school, we're going to open it up and try it out. Yeah, I mean, that's pretty much it for my pickups. Actually, for the other part of this update video, I wanted to let you guys know, you know, my friend here, Pete Dore, everybody knows Pete, he has an excellent channel. He just put up a video the other day talking about a website called GameGavel.com. It was formerly called Chase the Chuck Wagon. I've been a member of that site for just about a year now. I do have a seller's account. I haven't really done anything with that, but his video from the other day really, you know, enticed me to, you know, eventually start putting up some things for sale on there. Yeah, so you know, I'll most likely put the link to GameGavel in the video here on the sidebar. Also, I'll probably link to my online store there, which really doesn't have anything in it. I was just working out all the details of it. I made a banner for it just last night, and I put, you know, all my information, you know, my contact information, and, you know, basically it would be like, you know, PayPal payments to get the items, and there's going to be a whole number of various things on there, everything from, like, you know, Atari 2600 all the way up to the current gen stuff. You know, just some things from my collection and some other things that I've been, you know, picking up over the past few months. I haven't really been, you know, too actively playing and stuff. I'm going to probably put up there for sale. I mean, at this point already, I mean, I'm definitely, you know, still a gamer, and I still love all the old school stuff and the new school, but, you know, I'm trying to weed out some of my collection, and, you know, I figured the best way to do it would be to, you know, put it on some type of an auction site. I'm not really all too, you know, keen on eBay as far as selling because of the fees are just phenomenal, but I'm going to try it out on this, you know, GameGavel.com, which is formerly Chase the Chuck Wagon, so, you know, be on the lookout for that. Probably in the next video that I do, you know, once I have some of the stuff up there, you know, for purchase or whatever, I'll let you guys know, you know, just in general, just saying, oh, I have a few items up, whatever. I mean, right now I don't. I'm still, you know, working out all the details, and I have to take pictures of the stuff that's going to be going up so I can put it up on there and, you know, figure out what's going on with some other things going on with my bank and stuff, you know, as far as the fees and setting enough money aside to put all that stuff up for you guys to check out. But, yeah, I mean, I want to thank Pete Dore once again for putting that video up. It kind of, you know, gave me the extra kick in my ass to finally do some more stuff there on GameGavel. It's a very cool marketplace. Not a whole lot of people on it just yet. But, you know, I mean, sometimes you can get some real good deals on there. I found a number of games. on there, you know, some game lots and stuff. I found a PS2 game lot that I had purchased about a year ago, and you know, it's really cool. It's a real like easygoing site. It's not all like up in your face like how eBay is, you know. But yeah, I mean, I guess that's pretty much it for my video here. I also want to thank Johnny Millennium over at the Happy Console Gamer for mentioning me in a shout-out video. You know, it's pretty much like a community spotlight kind of thing, and I was in part two of that, and I was just, you know, one of the extra people that was at the end, you know, just with your channel name kind of flashing by, and I had a link there also, and I've gotten about 80-plus subscribers, brand new subscribers, you know, just from that little tiny mention, and that was real awesome. And I did want to, you know, go ahead and thank Johnny Millennium for that. And I hope all you guys are doing well. You know, I'm still around. I'm still, you know, getting going with all the gaming and stuff. I've been actually doing some of the MAME emulator stuff again. This really cool site called CoolROM.com. If you guys don't know about it, I'll mention that also in the sidebar. If you have MAME, I found some games in MAME that I was missing, you know, in the MAME version that I had, and, you know, certain fighting games and some side-scrollers and stuff, and I've been playing them, you know, kind of going back into the glory days of the whole arcade stuff. But, yeah, I mean, other than that, too, I also have an iPod Touch, the 3G. I have the 32-gigabyte model, and, you know, I've been buying some games off of that, too. I'm actually looking to maybe, you know, mod it. So that way I can put the different firmware on there, and I can put, like, emulators and stuff. There's a thing you can play MAME through iPod Touch, but a lot of the games don't work. Maybe about 50 games or so will function for it, but I'm looking into the details of that. I downloaded the software and, you know, the firmware hack thing. So I'm going to see if I can get going with that. I've been watching some of the videos here from some of the members of the YouTube community about it, and it seems really cool. It's just a little bit frustrating. So, you know, once I get that situated, I'll probably just put a little bit of an update on that. I mean, it's not all too much gaming related, but the way that I want to do it is, you know, to hack it to play MAME and some other games that are free. So, yeah, I mean, I'm kind of rambling on right now. So, I mean, this video wasn't even planned. It was just the game came in the mail, and I was thinking to myself, I haven't really done anything in over a month, and, you know, I miss talking to a lot of you guys out there, you know, guys and gals, of course. So, I hope everybody has a great week and things are going well, and I'll talk to everybody soon. Take care. Thanks.